Apple this week began stocking a new 4K 23.7-inch LG Ultra Fine display. And while Mac Rumors had a chance to go hands-on with it, by the way, there is a video that it goes along with this. Link to this article will be in the show notes. This replaces the original 21.5-inch 4K LG UltraFine display that was pulled from retail stores and the Apple online store earlier this year. They picked one up and thought we'd check it out to see if it's worth the $700 price point. Now, here's what they think. The new 4K display looks quite similar to the prior generation 4K and 5K ultra-fine displays, with a black plastic body with relatively thick bezels and a black aluminum stand. Like prior models, it can be VESA-mounted if you prefer. Now, it's larger than the original 4K ultra-fine display, as it measures in at 23.7 inches instead of 21.5, but it features a 3840 by 2160 resolution rather than a 4096 by 2304 resolution like the first model. Still considered Ultra HD, though, and qualifies as 4K. Now, though this display has a 4K resolution, it's not meant to be used at the full 3840 by 1260 resolution, given its display size, because everything on the display would be super small. Instead, it's meant to provide retina clarity when downscaled to a more reasonable resolution, like 1920 by 1080 or 2560 by 1440, which is what they set it to. Along with the larger display size, the new ultra-fine display features two Thunderbolt 3 ports instead of a single port, which means you can daisy-chain two of these monitors together. Now, they didn't have a second one on hand, but used daisy-chaining with a different 4K display, and it worked out. Now, you can also connect other Thunderbolt 3-enabled accessories directly to the display if preferred, and there are also three additional USB-C ports. Both a Thunderbolt 3 and USB-C cable are included. There's no webcam, but there are built-in stereo speakers available, much like the prior version of the LG UltraFine displays available from Apple. So, quality. Display is crisp and vivid, rivaling the Retina display on Apple Macs, and they like the high-gloss finish despite the fact that it adds a little bit more glare. Now, with 500 nits of brightness, it's fairly bright, and because it has P3 wide color support, all the colors are rich and true to life. So, yeah, it looks pretty good. So we'll have to see. I don't know.